Get ready to match the stars. Robert Q. Lewis, Brett Summers, Morey Amsterdam, Joyce Bulifant, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene.
Thank you. Hi, Johnny. How are you? All right. You're a dandy bunch, and I thank you for helping us out here.
Boy, he looks just like he does on television, don't
he? Hello, Morey. Nice to see you back here. And here's my old friend, Robert Q. Lewis. He's new to this show. We're very happy to have you. And this lady is new to the show, too, so let's welcome them specially. Are you ready to have a go at this, Joyce?
Yes, you look very handsome. I like that suit.
Thank you. Flattery will get you everywhere.
I was hoping so.
Hey, listen, I saw you do an interview show today with a lady who wrote a book called No Man Is Perfect.
Some men are more perfect than others.
I'm going to go out and buy that book.
That's the name of the book, yeah.
Yeah, that was very good. You
As
did
I
that
said
very
to her, enough about me.
Yes.
It's a good book. It's a good book.
It is. Now, let's say hello and welcome our current champion. Here is Ellen Hoey. Hi, Ellen. Ellen has won two games. She's got $6,200 to her credit. And when we were together last time, she had just finished the first part of the super match and won $500 in the audience match. And now she's going to have a go at $5,000. Are you ready for that, Ellen?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we'll get to it right after we do this message for you. Okay, here we are with Ellen Hoey. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay, now you know you've won the $500 in the audience match. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect that money, you must match one celebrity on the head-to-head basis. It's time to choose that celebrity now. Which one will it be, Ellen?
Ann Elder.
Ann. Beautiful Ann Elder. Are you ready? You get ready to write. All right, Ann? And Ellen, you face me. Here is the $5,000 question. Anne, please write your answer to this, if you would. Milk blank. Milk blank. Okay, the bell indicates that Anne is finished, and now, Ellen, it's time for you to give us your response. How do you fill in the blank? Milk?
Shake.
Milkshake. All right, Ann, for $5,000. You like that answer?
Yeah.
Well, won't you be surprised when you find out what Ann has written? We'll all find out together right now, Ann. May we see it?
I like that answer, too. So therefore, I said, shake!
Oh! Oh, boy. You are up to $11,200.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think, Ellen, the most we've given away is $12,000 is about the most we've given away, I think. How much? 13. Well, you're getting close to the all-time high on the show. How do you feel?
Nervous.
Are you nervous? Money makes you nervous?
Uh-huh.
It calms me down.
Maybe we can work something out.
I didn't hear it.
She said...
What did she say?
She said, money makes me nervous. I said, money calms me down. She says, maybe we can work something out. Dickie does the jokes, and you win the money, okay?
No, you got the money. You did the
joke. All right. Ellen, you're still a champion. You're going to play another game, so let's meet your challenger right now. Here comes Ramona Lewis.
Darling.
Hello, Ramona.
Hello.
Now, don't fall down as you step up there. You ladies know each other, do you? Welcome, Ramona. And Please tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a housewife. I have three sons, and my hobby is bowling.
Your hobby is what?
Bowling.
Bowling. Mm-hmm, oh, what's your lifetime average?
120. I just started.
Oh, 120. Well, you're young.
Thank you.
In a couple of years, you'll be bowling 100. Who knows? So. Okay, Ramona, shall we have a go at it? I'll push this button and reveal the two things there, and you got the choice.
All right, I like B, please.
You want B?
Yes.
Everybody plays. Brand new game. Here we go.
Grumpy the dwarf said,
I wish I were a little taller. I'm tired of kissing Snow White on her blank.
Not the idea. Listen, you can laugh out loud if you'd like, though.
You're out of your mind.
You think about that, Ramona. Grumpy the dwarf said, I wish I were a little taller. I'm tired of kissing Snow White on her blank. There. All right, the upper tier is ready. And here we go. Now, we call for your response. I'm tired of kissing Snow White on her...
behind.
Really?
Depends which way you look at it.
I don't... All right, Ramona, that's her answer. It's show and tell time, Robert. May we see your answer?
Yeah, all I can think of is Walt Disney, and he would never have permitted that, so it's tummy.
Tummy, yes. Okay.
Snow White's fairy godmother said, never turn your back on a dwarf. Navel.
Navel is her answer. Okay, Morey.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Navel is his answer. Joyce, what did you say?
Well, my dwarf is very short, so he was kissing her on her knee.
Boy, that is some short dwarf.
Short dwarf.
Yes, indeed it is. How about you, Richard?
Who put him up to it, you think? Yeah, I said knee as well.
Knee, that's two knees in a row.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
We're happy with it.
For a third knee in a row.
Third knee there. All right, the knees have it. Okay, Ramona, you didn't score with that, and we'll see how you do with yours, Ellen, in a moment or so. But first, we've got this message for you. All right, here we go, ladies. With the second half of round one, Ramona finished her half, did not score. And now we'll see if Ellen scores with this. Listen carefully now. Bruno's breath is terrible because he gargles with blank. Bruno's breath is terrible because he gargles with blank.
Did you say Bruno, dear?
Bruno, yes.
Bruno.
I know him well.
You know Bruno?
Oh, yeah. Gargles fast.
Bruno. All right. You ready over there?
Oh, yeah.
Brett, we're going to wait for you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess.
Come on, Brett.
Oh. I knew a guy once had such a bad breath on Halloween, we used to tip him over.
All right, Ellen. You've had plenty of time to think. They're all finished now. How do you fill in that blank? Bruno's breath is terrible because he gargles with...
Booze.
All right, that seems like a pretty good answer to me. Robert, what'd you say?
Listen, I'm delighted to know you, sweetheart. Like, see you after the show.
Booze. There it is. Okay, Brett.
Why, right, that won't make your breath bad. That'll make people love you.
Oh.
Sheep dip. You make it with cream cheese and clams.
Well,
I think mine is just as good. Sani flush.
Boy, that'll do it. Joyce, aren't you glad you came to the party?
Sani flush.
May we see your answer?
Yes, you may see my answer. I think that Bruno has a sore throat, so he's gargling with salt.
Salt.
P-U.
Dumb answer.
I can smell like a fish.
It's very good for you.
Clear her out
very
of the building.
Good answer.
Thank
good
you
answer.
So
all right, Richard.
You won't forget at the Christmas party. I haven't know that he gargled with garlic.
Now, garlic.
I have to explain.
Yes.
You must never eat at his house because he makes his spaghetti sauce with Lavoris. So don't ever eat grapes.
Okay, booze is the answer we're looking for.
I'm looking for that answer, too, but I have to say...
Garlic. Yeah, well, great mind. That's all right, you can kiss, because you both had garlic. That's enough.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so at the end of round one, the score is 1-0 in favor of our current champion. We go to round two and ask Ramona to make a selection.
I'll try B again, please.
B again it is. Since you match no one that first round, everyone will participate in the second round. The cannibal said, gee, that new restaurant is great. I ate the blank.
Mind repeating that, doctor?
The cannibal said, gee, that new restaurant is great. I ate the blank.
It's only on the hard ones that I don't come right up with the answer.
All right, everybody's ready. Hold it, Ramona.
I didn't hear it.
Yes, I'll do it for you.
Okay.
The cannibal said,
yes.
Gee, that new restaurant is great. I ate the blank.
Okay.
Is he a person?
Agreeable contestant.
I ate the okay. What the heck, then? Yes.
I
ate the...
It's a great restaurant?
Yeah. I mean, a really great restaurant. So great, he says, I ate the blank.
I ate the whole thing.
She said, I ate the whole thing. Now, did you...
No, give it to me again. Please.
It's the last reading.
Okay.
No. Sorry, okay. The judge says your answer is. What it is, the whole thing. All right, Robert, what'd you say?
Ramona, he had more gourmet tastes. He ate the chef.
He ate the chef. Yeah. Brett,
well, that's interesting because I said chef, too.
Chef, too. No match there.
It's a cheap restaurant. He ate the cook.
He ate the cook, yeah. And Joyce.
I was in the same gourmet restaurant. He ate the chef.
All right. And we're getting down to the wire. You've got to match one celebrity to stay in the running here. Richard?
Well, the chef was the person that cooked the food.
Right.
He ate the waiter.
He ate the waiter, right. You must match Anne or the game is over. Go, Anne.
I said the waiter.
The waiter. So Ellen Hoey wins another game. Congratulations, Ellen. And come on down, please. All right. Nice to see you again. Another $100 for Ellen and for Ramona. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 73.
Thank you very much.
Ramona Lewis. Goodbye, Ramona.
This your third time up here?
Yes, it is.
You've done very well. You could become the new all-time big money winner here on Match Game 73. Let's see if it happens. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Belly blank, or belly blank. Now, you know the answer they gave most often is worth $500, and second $250, and the third $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help, so which one do you want to choose first?
Ann Elder.
Ann, belly...
Button.
Belly button, she says. All right, another one?
Robert.
I like that one. Belly up.
Belly up?
Belly up.
Belly up.
To the ball. Belly up.
Belly up to the
ball. Barroom phrase. All right, one more.
Richard.
Belly dancer.
Belly dancer. Okay, so you've got belly button, belly up, and belly dancer. You may choose one of those three, as you know, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Belly button.
Belly button.
Yeah.
You think that's a good idea? Okay, the audience thinks you're right with that. That's the answer that Ann gave you. Let's see if it's up there anywhere. First, may we see the $100 response. Belly laugh is a good answer, but nobody thought of that, is it? Very good. Okay, still no belly button. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Belly button is there. Okay. You and Ann are doing very well together, aren't you? Okay, belly up was a third choice there. Let's find out before we go on, Ellen, what is under. What do you think, audience?
Dancer.
Belly dancer?
Belly ache.
Belly ache? All right, belly dancer is under the $500 response. Okay, you won the $250. Now you'll play for 10 times that amount or $2,500. Which celebrity do you want to try to match on a head-to-head basis?
Oh, boy. Robert.
Okay.
All right, Robert, you get ready to write.
Yep.
Ellen will face me. Here's the $2,500 question. It has to be an exact match in this instance. Good blank. Good blank. Good blank. ready now. I think a win here would make you the new all-time money champ. You're up to $11,550, is that right? And $2,500 added to that? It'd be a lot of money anyway. How do you fill in this blank? Good?
Well, I'm having a good time, so that's what I'll say.
Good time. You say good time. Mm-hmm. All right, Bob, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
Yeah. Good night.
Good night. All right, so you didn't collect the $2,500, but you did collect an additional $250, and you're still the champ. We'll meet another player right after we pass along this message to you. Okay, we're ready to play another game here on Match Game 73. To do that, we've got to introduce a new player, so let's welcome Mr. Jerry Mayo. Hi, Jerry.
Hello.
Hello, Ellen.
Yeah. She's winning all the money.
She's won a lot of money.
Yeah, lots of money.
Let's find out a little bit about Jerry Mayo.
From Alhambra, I'm a used car dealer. Very happy used car dealer.
You're all happy. I never saw none happy.
Would you buy a used car from this man?
You would. Yes, you would. You would. I've got good cars. You would buy
You
them.
Married?
Oh, I'm married. Oh,
he's on.
I've got...
He's on.
Did you bring him with you tonight?
Pardon, I didn't
hear
you.
Do you have an elephant?
Yes, I would. Come on over. I got anything you want if you just come over.
That's enough of that.
Better start right. Selling Stanley steamers.
Shall we play this game, Jerry?
Yes.
You know how it goes.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll push this button and ask you to make a selection. We leave that up to you because some of our contestants find some questions more difficult than others.
All right. I'll take B.
And some of your panel numbers.
B. Are you ready?
Yep. Yes.
Here we go. Abdullah has 100 wives.
And? Imagine walking in the bathroom and seeing 100 pairs of pantyhose hanging there.
That's another program, Morey. Oh.
Abdullah has 100 wives and not one of them is blank. I think we stopped the used car sales for there. He's thinking about it, though. Abdullah has 100 wives and not one of them is blank. All right. Lower tier is ready. All right, now we're all set over there, Jerry. So we call on you for your response. Not one of them is...
Young. I am stuck with it, you know.
Go
the audience thinks you blew it, Jerry. Gene thinks you blew it, too. No, I don't know. Listen, you never know. By these people, you really can't tell. Young is his answer. Let's see if it happens. It may. You'll never know. Robert, what do you say?
Abdullah, huh?
Abdullah had 100 wives, and not one of them is...
Jewish.
Okay. All right, Brett.
Jack Klugman is Jewish, Robert. Not one of them is pretty.
Not one of them is pretty. 100 wives is not a pretty one.
I Morey, said the same say? Thing. That's why he sleeps with his grandfather.
Young is Jerry's answer. Joyce, what's yours?
Well, I think he's been looking and looking for a pretty one, and not one of them's pretty.
Pretty is the answer. So far, it's come up more often than any others. How about you, Richard?
Well, Abdullah, you know, was not a pleasant fellow. He was a bit of a pill.
Oh.
So not one of them was pregnant.
Okay. Anne, what did you say about
it? I know. Richard and I spend too much time together. I said with child.
With child. Yeah. Right. So, Jerry, you didn't score with that at all. Now let's see if Ellen scores with this. They took Nutty Nelson away. After he was found putting brassieres on blanks. You remember Nutty Nelson, Joyce?
Yes.
Well, they took him away after he was found putting brassieres.
No.
You didn't hear
at
it.
All. I'm
oh, well, I'll be glad to repeat it for you, Ellen.
Okay.
Right here. You ready over there, Morey? I don't
sure.
see your light on.
Sure.
Your light is not on, Morey.
That's not Maybe my fault. I'm not the electrician here, kid.
Now your light is on, Morey. Okay. They took Nutty Nelson away after he was found putting brassieres on blanks. I think we stopped her, too. You know what brassieres are? They're those... they're like big earmuffs, you know?
statues.
On statues. That sounded like a desperation answer, but the audience seems to approve of it. Robert, what do you say?
Well, that was my second answer. My first answer, though, he was really nutty. Put him on cows.
Put him on cows. I see.
What did you say his name was?
Nazi. What's that?
Nutsy Nelson. Yes, I know him well, and he used to put brassiers on boys. Oh. Boy.
Well, that's Nutty Nelson, all right.
I know him, too. He was in the produce business. Cantaloupes.
Cantaloupes. What do you say about Nutty Nelson?
Oh, he was running around my neighborhood last week putting him on dogs.
On dogs? He was nutty, all right. How about you, sir?
The reason they called him Nutty Nelson was because he put them on coconuts. It's the only way you get the milk. I'm just leveling with you. You won't get it from cantaloupes, believe me.
And
you know, I think Dickie Dawson was born in a plain brown wrapper.
Yes.
Actually, he put them on animals.
Animals. All right. Okay. Ellen, you didn't score at all with that. And we'll get back to the two of you. But first, we've got this message for you. We're out of time. You'll both come back next time. We'll play round two, okay?
Good.
All right.
We thank you for joining us. You were all terrific.
I think so.
Joyce, look forward to seeing you on Love Thy Neighbor and look forward to seeing you next time. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 73. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are for Montgomery Ward's Christmas catalog, a remote-controlled wireless clock radio operates lights, TV, or coffee pot automatically from the Montgomery Ward catalog. And Snowy Bleach, the exclusive blended formula with extra washes per box, safe for whites and colors, Snowy Bleach. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dish that's so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection, Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.